Cersei Lannister may just be one of the most hated characters in the history of television. The ruthless queen will stop at nothing to maintain her own power and will destroy anyone who she believes threatens her or her family. In my opinion, Cersei is the best villain that the show has ever seen, and currently the best character on the show. The version of Cersei Lannister portrayed in Game of Thrones is, not surprisingly, quite different from the one in which George R. R. Martin created in his A Song of Ice and Fire book series. The version of Cersei Lannister in Game of Thrones is far more relatable and is more humanized in the viewer's eye than she ever was in the books. Take the exchange between Catelyn and Cersei in Season 1 after Bran is pushed from the Broken Tower. Cersei tells the story of her first and only child with Robert Baratheon, a child with dark hair that died soon after its birth. Cersei tells no such story in the books, but the show version of Cersei seems to have been earnest and quite emotional when she recounted the story to Catelyn. Right from the start, Cersei is demonstrating to be a character containing a significant amount of emotional depth. In George R. R. Martin's novels for the first three books, Cersei comes across as merely a vindictive, arrogant, and cruel person, in many ways fulfilling the trope of the evil queen. But it is not until A Feast for Crows, Book 4, that we see the world from Cersei's point of view, and even then, she is still not relatable in the same way that Cersei Lannister is relatable in the show. In the books, most, if not all, of Cersei Lannister's actions stem from her encounter as a girl with the woods witch, Maggie the Frog, who warned her of a dark fate which awaited her in the future. Much of her paranoia regarding the Tyrells and Tyrion stems from this. Her encounter with Maggie the Frog is somewhat translated to the show, but the television show version of Cersei is driven by more complicated and slightly less selfish motives. The key distinction between book Cersei and show Cersei is that the television version truly loves and wants to protect her children. The book version of Cersei views her children as an extension of herself. As each of Cersei's children dies, this represents to Cersei a ticking clock counting down to her own demise. By contrast, in Season 2 of Game of Thrones, when Cersei fears that the Battle of Blackwater is lost, she attempts to poison her son Tommen Baratheon in order to spare him of the agony that would come if he was captured by Stannis Baratheon. Cersei did this out of love for Tommen, out of a desire to spare her son of unnecessary suffering. There is no such scene in the books. When Cersei learns that Tyrion plans to ship Marcella to Dorne, she reacts emotionally in the show. In contrast, in the books, Cersei treats Marcella as an unusually valuable bargaining tool. She does not like Tyrion's plan, but does not appear to be hurt by the loss of her daughter in the same way that the show version of Cersei does. Show Cersei even says to Tyrion later, "One day I pray you love someone. I pray you love her so much when you close your eyes you see her face. I want that for you. I want you to know what it's like to love someone, to truly love someone, before I take her away from you." Cersei may have ultimately failed as a mother due to her own flaws, but one cannot deny that she actually did truly care for her children. The fact that Cersei shows a capacity for true love immediately makes her a more compelling villain than Joffrey or Ramsay, who seem to be cruel merely for the sake of being cruel. Show Cersei is not merely driven by greed or a desire for power or sadism, but also by the love she has for her children. Is there any wonder that the showrunners chose to impregnate Cersei again? With her last child, Tommen, dead, and her revenge over the Tyrells and the Sand Snakes complete, what other motivation would Cersei have? In Season 3, Cersei says to Tyrion that without her children, she would have thrown herself from the highest tower in the Red Keep a long time ago. Cersei's love, however, does not extend beyond her children, and I would argue that her incestuous relationship with her brother Jaime is more based on dependency than love in both the novels and the show. Cersei viewed all others with suspicion and met them with hostility, whether she presented it covertly or overtly. To Cersei, other people are tools. Being the daughter of Tywin Lannister, she had lived like royalty her entire life. Everyone else was beneath her. Cersei's arrogance is her greatest vice. But one thing that cannot be denied is that she learns from her mistakes, and is willing to do what it takes to get what she wants. It was Cersei that said to Ned, "When you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die." I think Cersei understands this notion better than anyone. Not only is Cersei surviving the Game of Thrones, currently she's winning it. Olenna Tyrell once taunted Cersei, asking if she intended to kill all her enemies. And in one move, Cersei accomplished just that. Cersei is an excellent villain because we understand her motivations. We know what she wants, and we know why she wants what she wants. She is not merely an evil woman doing evil things for the sake of being evil. The evil things that she does are justified within her own mind, brought forth out of a deep desire to protect herself and to protect the few that she loves. And we can't talk about Cersei without talking about Lena Headey's fantastic portrayal of the character. I would say that about 60% of the reason that the character works so well in the show is because of her fantastic acting. Lena Headey perfectly delivers all of the subtle nuances of Cersei's complex emotions. She manages to balance Cersei's inherent cruel nature with undertones of vulnerability and her earnest protective maternal instincts. A lot of what makes Lena Headey's performance in Game of Thrones great is her ability to non-verbally communicate the way Cersei is feeling, sometimes through her facial expressions alone. Lena Headey has been the most consistent actor on the show, and in my opinion, is the best actor currently on the show. Cersei Lannister is without a doubt a bad person, by any metric, and I am not defending her. But she is a realistic bad person, and even in some cases, a sympathetic one. When Cersei is held captive in the Sept of Baelor, it is hard not to feel at least somewhat bad for her. And when Cersei finally conquers the Faith, it is a vindicating moment not just for Cersei, but for the viewers as well. When Cersei avenges the death of her innocent daughter, Myrcella, it is a moment that many viewers relish in. When compared to a character like Ilaria Sand, Cersei is far more believable as an antagonist because her actions make sense. Once you understand how Cersei's mind works, it is simple to see the logic of her behavior. There is no character on the show at this point which matches Cersei in character depth, including Jon and Dany, who have both grown more one-dimensional as the seasons have gone on. Cersei Lannister is the best developed and most complicated character of the series, followed by Theon and Jaime. Whatever happens to Cersei in the final season, it is obvious that she has shown much more resilience than many thought she had. No matter where the game ends for her, she played it well.
If you ever call me sister again, I'll have you strangled in your sleep.
If you enjoyed this video, consider supporting this channel on Patreon. For more videos on Game of Thrones or Song of Ice and Fire, check the playlist on the front page of this channel. Also, you can follow me on social media by searching Ideas of Ice and Fire on Facebook or Twitter.